Sloan are an alt-rock band from based in Toronto, Canada, although originally they were from Halifax, Nova Scotia. They were formed in 1991 and still impressively have the same four members as they had when they started. They have released a steady stream of albums. Their 13th album is due for release right now at the point as I'm recording this intro. Hi, my name is Dan. So this was Sloan's third album. It's my first time listening to it, but it is the second time that I've reviewed a Sloan album. So I also reviewed Twice Removed by them not too long ago, I think. So I did what I sometimes do when I'm in these circumstances, which is I didn't actually go back and look at the other review until I'd finished writing this one. And I found that the scores are pretty similar between the two. I don't want to be, you know, too influenced by previous opinions of different albums, even if it's my own opinion. Right, anyway, so let's crack on. So I would describe this as being pop rock. Quite a few people have described it as being, when I say quite a few, I mean Wikipedia and Acclaim Music, have described it as being power pop. excuse me, I'm not sure what the difference is between those two terms. I would naturally gravitate towards the term pop rock as being kind of, you know, rock, but it's got pop elements in that, you know, hook lines that are easy to remember and choruses and stuff like that, very accessible. I think that that is essentially the same as the description of what power pop is, but if you know better, please tell me. I'd love to know. Through the comments box, of course. Now, apparently this album cost a tenth to make compared to their previous album. And apparently it's also their first album to include trumpets. So this sounds like a cross between, occasionally there's kind of hints here of pop punk, I would say. Maybe not quite as punky and heavy as like The Offspring and Green Day and stuff like that, but that kind of edge to it. But then the other big influence there is the Beatles. Very strongly, that can be heard throughout, is that the chord sequences, the tunes, the possibly even the subject matter at times is very Beatles-like. So this is one of those albums that effectively kind of, it rolled off my back. It's pleasant enough, but it, you know, like water off a duck's back. It didn't make a lot of impact. I found it hard to remember it afterwards. When I went, kind of went back and started listening to, you know, after the second listen, went back and hearing little snatches as I'm writing the review, I go, oh, yeah, I remember that. I had occasional thoughts like, so there's a track, The Lines That You Amend. The start of that reminded me of, oh, what does that remind me of? Proud Mary by Creedence Clearwater Revival, or Stuck in the Middle with You by, I can't remember who. Just is just the guitar rhythm and the way that it's being played. Musically, it's reasonably varied. Occasionally, it's got interesting words. Somehow, it didn't really grab me that much. Maybe it was just trying a little too hard to be the Beatles, I felt. And so, kind of in my head, maybe I was still going, yeah, but it's not the Beatles. So, and I know it's not. I need to judge it on its own merits, but it didn't make a huge impact. So that's what I think. I'm still giving a reasonable score. What do you think? Please do talk to me through the comments box. That's it from me for now.